Hi, I'm Matty Dawes, and today I'm going to show you how to catch loads of fish this summer on the Mudline. Now you may have heard the term mudline fishing before. Now what is this really all about? Well, simply, on the far bank of the canal style lakes, there's an area of the canal where it's a lot more shallower and normally a bit of bare bank and mud. That's technically what's why it's called mudline. So what this enables you to do is get a nice shallow water, you can get in the correct depth and catch them carp and F1s. With the weather being so good in the summer months, the fish want to feed in shallower water. So when you're fishing in the mudline, it's a perfect place to catch them. Now, plumbing up on the mudline is essential to get the right depth. And what I mean by this is, the right depth for really the mudline is between 1 foot and 2 foot. It's gonna differ on the different venues you go to. So when looking on the mudline, you don't really want it any shallower than 12 inches and you don't really want it any deeper than 2 foot, as this can cause you problems with line bites and miss bites and foul hookers. But also the reverse effect is the 12 inches. So if you go below that, you might not get the fish coming in your peg as often, so you can catch them. So you need to think about where you're fishing and how you're fishing. What I like to do is just set up foot markers on my cupping kit and then register it on my pole. So when I'm plumbing up my rigs, I can see today we're just under 2 foot. So this enables me to know what to feed and when to feed and how I need to react with different pots. Now, if I was to go to mudline today and it was 1 foot deep, I'd probably look to feed a little bit different because I've got a lot less shallow water and the fish can't stay in my peggers longer. Now what I mean by this is, if you start feeding loads and loads of bait, leaving particles on the bottom, the fish can come in and stay in your peg. So next time you go in, you might end up foul hooking the fish. But if it's shallower, the fish aren't naturally going to want to stay into 12 inches for that long period, so it makes them easier to catch. So just when you're fishing, just make sure you're in the right depth. Mind this, you're tight to the bank, so you're not off the bank, you're tight to it, so it stops some fish coming behind your rig, and the rig suits this as well. So one thing to think about, just think about where you're fishing and what depth you're in. If it's over 2 foot, you might have to fish a different way, but in between 1 foot and 2 foot is perfect for the mudline. Now, rigs for mudline fishing couldn't be simpler. There's a few key aspects though to get right to help you catch more fish. Now, the first one is short hook lengths. So it's either a 3 or a 2 inch hook length. So it now enables you to have a solid bulk next to your hook length to get your rig straight in position and fishing dead quickly. That's really important. The float matches this as well. So it's a really heavy float for a sort of fishing 4x14 carp shallow. So when we get our bait in, we put our rig straight in and it gets in there straight away. Now, it's got 2 backshot just to control the rig, that's 2 number 8. Now, the elastic is really important as well. This time I'm using a 13 Jura slip. Now, this may seem harsh, but in a short kit, I can hook the fish, they can glide out my peg, I get 4 or 5 foot of elastic gliding out the peg, and then when I get to my top kit, I can lift them up with ease. So it makes me nice and efficient in my matches. There's not elastic everywhere. I'm not putting too much pressure on the fish when I'm playing it, which may cause hook pulls. So it's a nice all-round elastic and fantastic for fishing up to mud. Now, feeding your mudline is going to be all through pots. Now, you may see here, I've got 4 different sizes of pots, and this is really important depending what fish you're catching. So what I'm going to do is talk you through the reasons why I use different sizes in different situations. Now, I've got my big cupping kit pot and a medium pot. Now, if I was fishing carp venues where they're a bit bigger fish, you're waiting a little bit longer for bites, you feed a bigger volume to draw them fish in, then that's when I'd look to feed with a big pot, say half fillet, or a medium cab pot if you were getting a few fish coming in at a time. Now, the smaller pots are suited for smaller carp and F1 venues where you've got a lot of fish coming in, a lot of mouths to feed, and you want to control the amount of feed that's going in your peg. So the small pot is ideal for a standard start of to your session, but if you're getting loads of fish coming in, you can get away with a cut in half pot, which is just a small with the top taken off it. You can catch them fish quicker and be more efficient. So now we've got all the details out of the way, let's get some fishing done and show you how to catch these fish in the mudline. So what I'm going to do, to start off with, I'm just going to put a piece of corn on. Now you may be thinking, well, why not an expander or a few bunch of maggots? It's just a piece of corn, nice and selective at this venue. You might go to different venues where different hook baits work, but I know a piece of corn is going to get me the quickest bat I need to. So all I'm going to do is fill my small pot up just to start with. Just get a few fish in the peg, and then we can decide whether we need to change the pots or change feeding. We might need to change a little ball, or we might need to just feed less micros and just try and trick them fish. Now, one little tip I want to give you when doing it is get yourself set before you go into your mud hole. The last thing you want is your rig coming in from the side and you're getting all over the place. You've got to be quick and efficient with this. I don't mean go in straight away and try and rush things. I just want to be nice and sensible, come in a line so you come straight away. So come to your mark, and I'm looking now where I need to be. So what I'm going to do is go to my mark, which is there, drop my pole in the water, let the holes on the back of the pot release the bait. So it's gone out, give it a little tap just to check. Lift your rig up, lower it in, and you're fishing straight away. Now, the reason why I said be quick is because this mud hole is slightly deep. It's just under 2 foot. Now, oh, there you go. Now, if I was a bit behind trying to set my rig, I could have missed my chance to catch that fish. So you've just got to be nice and quick, but not too quick where you're rushing. But as you can see, that 13 just gliding out, causing us no hassle there. Ship back nice and steady. Elastic's doing the work. See what I mean by that corn? It's nice and selective, so you get one straight away. There you go, a little carp. One thing, the beauty about corn as well is they are selective. You can get a little carp, and they're real weight build as these ones, so you can keep catching them in your matches and put a weight in it together, or if you're pleasure fishing, they're just nice to catch. So I'm gonna do the same again, because obviously we caught our fish nice and quick, but we had no signs to change. I'm just gonna make sure the elastic's tight in the end, fill that pot up, try not to hook the platform. It's really important about doing that same process right. So there, I'm going to get to say halfway down a 40 meter section. Now I'm going to set my little line to go in, dunk it underwater, let that water push out again. Just check it's all come out there. Put my rig straight on top of it and fishing straight away. So missed bite there. Now, one thing I want to say is if you miss a few bites, come back and do that little process again. So set your little trap again, repeat it, keep going with it. Last thing you want to do is sit there and not know whether you've got some bait on the bottom, getting a few liners and a few bites. You want them fish pinned to the bottom. So I'm going to give it one more now. And if I miss this bite, I'm going to come back and refeed again. Got him. Said you can see that elastic comes out, it's not too harsh. Sometimes you don't even need to use your puller kit on them, which I like doing at the minute, because if your hook hole's not perfect, you can pull the hook out. But if you just glide the fish up nice and gentle, you can with this elastic. There you go, nice big F1 that one. Nice big F1. These are the stamper fish you can get on the mud. They're normally a bigger stamp than normal as well. So the bigger fish, greedier ones coming to feed. Now, because I had a few bites there which I missed, I'm just going to make a decision to just change my pot. So I'm going to hook that piece of corn, and then I'm going to change to the smallest pot. Now, my reason behind this is I just think there's the odd fish coming in now, so I just want to cut the feed out and try and get them onto my hook bait as quick as possible. Once again, line it up, don't go flying into your mud straight away. Make sure everything's in the right place before you do it. Lower it down, check it out, lift it up, drop it in, fishing straight away. So when you're fishing up to these mud lines, fishing at the back of them, right tight to the island, it gives you the best option of, like I said, catching them biggest damp fish. And it's just an enjoyable way of fishing. Missed that bite then. So one thing we can do as well, if we get a few bites now, because we get a few line bites, we can change the way we feed one more time, so we can feed a tiny ball of micros, because there's a depth, like I said before, it's just under 2 foot. It's not ideal for the mud line. See that fish has moved my rig now. So what I'm gonna do is just come back again. Just feed again. Just feed quickly. It's a nice busy method this. In and out, thinking about changing your pots, changing your hook bait. Put 3 maggots on, 4 maggots even if you're trying to target some carp. We've got 4mm Pro Expanders with us today as well. So get lined up. Put that on there. Lift it up. Because we've got that 4x14 float on, it'll set that rig straight quickly. Last thing you want is like a 4x10 or 4x12 where it's wafting in. Just gives a chance for the fish to come in without you fishing in the right spot. If you've got a 4x14 or even 4x16. Sure, it was a bite then, I wasn't looking. You set your rigs nice and quick, your bulk's right by your hook. It also gives you a sharp, nice, positive indication on your float. That was nice and settled, hardly any liners, just a nice solid bite. So the fish tell you what you need to do with your pots. So you can either get in loads of signs, you can ball them up next. Or, feels a bit bigger this one. We can ball it up or we can go back to feeding our pot. It can just change the amount of fish coming in your peg all the time. Feel a better fish. I'm going to use my polar kit. I'm going to say it's going to be a little mirror, I reckon. Ooh. So you see how the light elastic on now? That fish could have had you under the pallet then, you could be setting a new rig up, or you could have lost him. Last thing you want to do is lose a 2-3 pound fish in a match. There you go. There we go. Bit hassle that one. But it's a lovely fish that one. Fully scaled little mirror. That one. Hook bang in the top lip as well. That's one thing to check, just where they're up. Just to make sure you're all plumbed up correct. You're in the right place. And fishing, so this time I'm just going to change, just see if putting 3 maggots on just gets us a different bite. Just change your hook bait up. Fill your pot up. Said, get in line before you actually get to your mud. Last thing you want to do is be rushing around and getting things wrong in that mud. Set your trap. Sit there nice and patient. Now the perfect bite is like that one then. I missed it though. Where you just sit there, no signs, and it just flies under 100 miles an hour. So again, if we're getting silly bites like this, we're missing them. And literally, could change, but that wasn't too bad, that one. Keep everything nice and low, nice and smooth. Straighten the poles up. Opposite left one. So one thing to notice as well, because we put three maggots on, we've caught an F1, so change back to core, we might catch a few more carp. Now if you're in any matches, you want to be looking for the biggest fish you can get in your peg, or keep getting in your net, so just put a bit of corn on, see if you can catch a carp again. One thing to do as well, if you feel like you want to catch some carp on the mud, try and feed a little bit more bait, so like a medium pot or even a large pot, or cupping with your cupping kit, just a bigger volume. Carp tend to like a bigger volume of bait more than F1s do. So if you can, a bit of weed there, just go past him. If you can put a bit more bait in, you're giving yourself a better chance to catch a carp, but all to be done in the right situation. Now one thing I do want to mention, we've got like a slight breeze coming down now. With using a short kit and a short free, just stiffens my pole up. So when you're fishing like this, everything's nice and stiff, it's not bouncing around. The last thing you want is it bouncing around and slowing you down for that chance to feed. You want everything dead stiff, straight out. It's nice and efficient fishing. You've just got to be like a little robot, go out, just do that process, come back. Last thing you want is anything that can hinder you to catch less fish. That's why it's ideal using a short stop and a short number three. Let's go. Now I had a few signs on that one, so what I'm gonna do, just change to feeding a little ball of micras, just to see if we can get them fish pinned down to the bottom. Still gonna put a piece of corn on the up, nice little F1. But I'm just gonna change to putting a ball of micras in. So I'm just gonna put my corn on again. I'll change my pot back to the small. I'm gonna just make a small nugget of micras. Not squeeze it too hard, just so it fills my pot. It just enables me to ship out of ease. Just try and catch a couple of fish doing this. Because one thing it'll do is just send it straight to the bottom and then pegs it a little bit deeper. Which gives you a better chance of catching them than a load of loose feed going through the water. So drop them in there. Drop them in. Put your rig straight on top of it. And you're just creating a like dead tight area. No loose feed coming through. I think that was me that, but thinking it's a bite. Oh. That's right. You see how much quicker that was just by changing the feeding ever so slightly. We just sent that nugget straight to the bottom in like a mug size area. Fish has come down, seen the hook bait, picked it up, quicker bite. Hey, up to tench. Look at that. Judy Dench. Lovely then. Not the carp we wanted, but I don't mind catching them. Right, I was just gonna have one more piece of corn on. Get all the slime off in that tench. Same again, I'm just gonna feed a little ball because that was a really quick bite, that one. That's what I was looking for. It's been nice and fast and efficient and steady. See, my pole sock's in the right place, so I can just pull my pole out nice and easy. My roll is set the right height, so I can just glide it across my knee, get it set in position and into the peg. Feed him in there. There you go. Much quicker bite than that ball of micros. This one's got to be a carp. Pull him back. just by changing your feeding a slightly different way to suit your peg, you can catch a tiny bit quicker. It's all them small 1% margins. Trying to do me under the bridge, this one. Keep them. I think it's a little common, I've just seen it. So the elastic's working perfectly. Got a nice balanced rig. Ooh. There we go. Get around the circles in. A nice little mirror. To end on, I'll just get him, show you up. Hook him up. So, nice little mirror out of the mud line to end on. So, hope you enjoy them tips and get on the bank and catch some more fish using them.